Good Tuesday morning. Welcome to the WLBB Community Voice program here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3. And this morning we are streaming live on the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page. So if you're at home and sitting comfortably in front of a computer, take a peek at the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page. And feel free to post your comments and questions throughout this morning's program. Our guest, Usama Ahmed, he's one of three challengers to Jim Waters for the Ward 3 City Council seat here in Carrollton. And kind enough to join us this morning. And I've talked to you on the phone a couple times, but good to finally meet you.
Well, thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
And I'm looking forward to being here more often if I can.
Well, yeah, good luck with that. Absolutely. You and I had talked previously on the telephone, and I don't think it's, for me to point this out is not a big shock to anybody. You have a different background than I'm going to say the rest of the candidates do. If you mind telling us about how you got to Carrollton.
I am an immigrant. I came to West Georgia as an international student in 2008. I came here to first study, but the longer I stayed in the United States, the more I started liking it. And there were certain moments in time where I kind of realized that the structure of the government here and the people, the overall environment is way better than the rest of the world, in my opinion, in my humble opinion, because I have actually seen worse too. So over time, I fell in love with the country and then the city as well. Because I've been here for 11 years. I met my wife here at the university, sophomore year. We've been together for about a decade now, and we have one child. And we also have accumulated along the way three cats and a dog, as most families in Carrollton, we love pets as well. So I do have an immigrant background, but I came to America with choice, legally, always been legal, and I became a citizen by my own choice instead of accident of birth for the love of the country and for the love of the community as well.
Well, it may seem like an easy question here, an obvious answer. What was that choice? Why did you make the decision? And how did you make the decision? How did it all come about?
So there were certain moments of time. Like one of them was I watched a movie called Pursuit of Happiness. That was by Will Smith. Yep. And first, the movie was about upward mobility, but which was my goal eventually too. To go up in life, social class, stuff like that, like the American dream. But also, the phrase kind of like hung to me. And after that, I started doing some research. And then that led to my research into the Constitution, Bill of Rights, and how everything, came about and how much the forefathers discussed everything in detail. And that led to me that this is one of the most balanced documents out there that represents and ensures that everybody's rights are kept. And it has. I don't know of any other nation that has kept the rights of the citizen and the form of government for hundreds and hundreds of years like America has.
And I imagine all that's fresher on your mind, not to challenge the other candidates, but because you have studied those things and probably had to learn more things. I mean, it's all fresher on your mind over the last 11 years. So you already married? You have a young child?
Yes. She's sweet as can be, 2 years old. She is wonderful about 95% of the time. Well, 5% of the time she is a toddler, have to deal with the negative as well as the positive.
Absolutely.
But she's wonderful. And that she is one of the reasons that actually I was like, all right, she is going to go to Carrollton City Schools, which are not bad schools, but I'm tired of hearing about Bremen. I want Carrollton City Schools to do better. I want Modar to get the best education while staying in Carrollton. And, there's plenty of reasons, but my daughter and her future education was one of them. Because I've decided to stay in Carrollton all my life.
I do want to get on your platform a little bit, but when you talk about you'd like to see better for the city schools, what do you think city council and city government can do to benefit the schools?
In budgetary decision making, when anything that comes to their approval as regard to finances or planning and all that, I know that Board of Education is separate, but whatever the City Council can do on decisions that affect the schools that come in front of them, basically supporting the schools in that. And also, you know, they can have a close ties to the Board of Education or the school board, basically, not the Board of Education, and nudge them a little bit more towards progress and more sensible spending than frivolous spending.
Usama Ahmed, our guest on this morning's Community Voice program, one of three challengers to current City Councilman Jim Waters for the Ward 3 City Council seat here in Carrollton. Election Day, November 5th, and I keep forgetting, 3 weeks before that, I know it's when early voting starts. What day is that? 14th, 15th?
I think so, 14th.
Okay, sometime in October, 3 weeks before November the 5th. Is, so plenty of time for early voting. Glad to get all the candidates in here before that happens. Well, let us talk more about your platform. Actually, you know, what did motivate you to seek this seat?
So, as I said, over time, this is the city I've known since I've been in the United States, and I have friends here, now family here and all that too. A lot of times when I come to like down Bankhead Highway, I enter the city, it feels like home. And I saw that the city's getting better, but I figured I can chip in and help it progress more. Because whenever you're blessed, whenever you're given blessings in life or opportunities, like the city has loved me, even though being an outsider, they've loved me as if their own, it's my job to give back. I haven't seen anybody long-term successful that doesn't give back. So I was looking for avenues to give back. I was thinking about volunteering in the soup kitchen, stuff like that. And then this opportunity popped up, and I was like, I don't have to leave my job for this. I can just, you know, dedicate time off work and help the city that's loved me. I can love the city back.
You called it an opportunity. Yeah. I mean, Jim Waters still would like to be a city council person. Is there something that you saw that has happened over the last 8 years, maybe a vote that you see different, or you would have done something different as far as the way he handled a vote, perhaps?
Well, no, I think the general direction of the city has been good. I met Jim yesterday, too, and he seems a pretty fine gentleman. I don't know him on a deeper level, but he seems a good fellow. Generally, what I want to do is to continue the progress that has been going on. I saw elements of it getting hindered. Part of it was the play that was getting blocked and all that. And we shouldn't be doing those kind of things, but in the general direction of the city has been good. Like, I love the amp, and the city council put the play area behind the amp. That's pretty good. Hobbs Farm, I play disc golf there. Love that place. I think it's rated pretty high in the United, like all overall right. United States. They're doing a fitness center there too, which is also good. I just want to expand on that. Like, I want to increase. I want to finish off the green belt. Maybe have a park close by the Hobbs Farm or somewhere else in the Greenbelt where, you know, you can just go out and have your children play without worries of traffic. I would also like a farmer's market. That's one thing that wasn't making as much progress. I would like to have a farmer's market somewhere close to the square, maybe behind the Little Hawaiian area, somewhere around that, where me, my family, or other families like us, you know, just Carrollton folks, can go buy some fresh produce and then go eat ice cream or eat lunch and just make a day out of a Saturday or a Sunday. That's one of the things that, you know, the quality of life attracted me about or made me fall in love with this city more, is that you have wonderful opportunities at the square where you can just go and have family entertainment. And I just want to expand on that. I saw that it wasn't expanding as well as it should.
That farmer's market that you would love to see on the square, is that are you picturing that being city-run, city-operated?
No, private. Like, you know, right now it's by Tanner.
Well, I think right now
Tanner,
they are discussing, actually in that area down, that's where they considered having the facility for the cotton mill farmer's market. it was in discussions. Mm-hmm. You know, it was never confirmed or never approved at this point, but that actually was in the discussion. Yeah, and I just wanted to clear that up. Usam Ahmed, one of three challengers to Jim Waters for the Ward 3 City Council seat here in the city of Carrollton. He's our guest this morning. Questions and comments, encourage you to visit the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page this morning and post those up there, and I'll take a peek during the break and see if we can throw them out here in our second segment. Community Voice brought to you by Tanner Health System, Oak Mountain Academy, here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3.
A well-rounded education includes much more than just academics. At Oak Mountain Academy, we encourage our students to find their niche in any of our 42 co-curricular opportunities. Over the past 5 years, we have brought home 5 state and 20 regional athletic titles. Our one-act play and literary teams continuously compete at the region and state level, and our academic teams bring home first place more than not. We are warriors creating legacies. To learn more, visit oakmountain.us.
At Tanner, we're advancing health throughout West Georgia and East Alabama because we know that exceptional care isn't based on how many patients we serve, but how well we serve them. That's why we're focused on quality, delivering the best possible care for our patients. It's why we're expanding our clinical services and building new facilities to serve our growing community. And it's why we're looking beyond our hospitals and medical practices to develop sustainable wellness and preventive health programs in our region. What makes a hospital great has changed. It's not how many beds we have. It's how well we care for the neighbors who need them. Delivering the right care to every patient, every time, is how Tanner is advancing health with medicine beyond measure. Learn more at Tanner.org. Or find a physician on our medical staff by calling 770-214-CARE.
All right, welcome back to the WLBB Community Voice Program here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3. And this morning we're streaming live on the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page. Encourage you to post your comments and questions there this morning, as Diane Cook Thompson already did. She said good morning to us, and good morning. Thanks for tuning in this morning, Diane. My guest is Usam Ahmed. He is, again, is one of three challengers to Jim Waters for the Ward 3 City Council seat here in Carrollton. The other two candidates, we had Jim on yesterday, Usam today, and we'll have the final two candidates on Thursday and Friday of this week at 8:30, so do hope you tune in for that program, especially if you do live in Ward 3. Where is Ward 3?
Ward 3, the Chick-fil-A on Bankhead Highway, if you take the other side of Bankhead Highway, south side of Bankhead Highway, all the way down to the square, Bankhead Highway is the dividing factor for Ward 2 and 3. And on the other side, it goes down towards close to the bypass, close to US 27. The maps are kind of drawn a little in unique ways where even there's a neighborhood right next to the high school that is part of Ward 3, but the rest of it is not. Oak Grove Mountain, Oak Grove Golf Course, that area is included as well. The Horsley Mill Road itself is not, but neighborhoods around it are included in Ward 3 as well.
And Joel, am I able to put this in front of one of the cameras? Is that able to be seen here? This is part of your posters that you're putting up. I'm assuming you can start today, right? Today's the first day that you're allowed to put these up, so you may see these around the Ward 3 in Carrollton. Did you get to see that? Okay. And so on that, one of your platforms, you talk about better pay for our police officers and firefighters. If we cannot pay well the people that put their lives in harm's way for us, then that is disgraceful, is the word there. We've talked about the last 2 years and maybe for the last 10 years, we're talking about the improving the pay for first responders and public safety. Carrollton City recently did a pay scale study. And have you seen the results of those? And how do you think Carrollton first responders?
I think first responders in general, not only Carrollton, are not well paid. We kind of ask a lot of them, sorry. And when it comes to pay them, we don't really empty our pockets and give the money they need. like, for example, I had to like ask for stats and get the stats from the city on their pay. It all started way back when I was in college, close to graduation. I worked in retail on Maple Street, and there's an officer that used to do wellness checks. I'm not sure if I'm allowed to say his name, so I will refrain from that. But I was talking to him like, hey, you know, I'm about to graduate. I'm looking at options on which sectors I want to go in. Do you mind if I know your salary? And he said at that point, he was in the force for like 5-6 years or more, and it was $37,000 then. And in my mind, I was like, I kind of want to make more than that when I graduate. So we're not, because of having low pay, we're not getting quality people in the police force and the fire and in the fire department in general. Like right now, the starting pay currently we're offering to the police candidate is $35,289. That ends up being, if you divide it per hour, 16.96 an hour. And I don't know if you've seen that board. If you go down 27 close to Columbia Drive, there's a board for Pilgrim's Pride, and that says you can make, you know, $15 an hour. And no disrespect to, you know, chicken plant workers, they probably work hard too, but in comparison, the police force are doing a lot more, putting their lives on the line, and we're just paying like them $2 more.
I think the QT gas station has a sign. I think managers of the QT gas station make $44,000. And again, you know, but it does stand out.
Yeah, that, like when I was, when I graduated, because I worked in retail, assistant manager at Quick Trip was one of the positions open. And at that point in 2012 or 2013, I forgot which year it was, they were offering $39,000 for an assistant manager position at Quick Trip. Mm-hmm. And they have multiple assistant managers. Like it's just not right. I think what happens is that today a year will pass, 2 years will pass, and the police force will either, some of them will leave to other better paying jobs, or they'll quit. You know, like they'll just go to other cities, and then you're not attracting new and better talent. You're not attracting enough college graduates, and then when it comes time to for an actual situation, a tragedy of sorts or something, then you're willing to like judge their split seconds. You go frame by frame and frame and say like, oh, you know, what did they do and what did they not do? Mm-hmm. I think that's just a general problem in the United States, but at least we can fix that in our city.
Well, what's the hump though? What's stopping the rates from going up for first responders for the city?
I don't know if the city council is allowed to vote on this. I think it's in the hand of the city manager, but the city manager is then, you know, answers to the city council. So the city council can encourage the HR department. I think Faith is the name for the HR director, mm-hmm. and then Jim Triplett. They can encourage those folks and the city manager in general to increase their pace. Because especially for a firefighter, you know, they work 24-hour shifts. They can go to Cobb County, do an hour commute, make more money, and then work 24 hours. Like an hour commute for a 24-hour shift is not that much difference. So first we have to be competitive, and then we have to like increase the pays in general, so we just attract a higher talent in general in the police force. Because it will not pay dividends this year, but it will pay dividends generations down the road. And you know, all of our children are going to live in Carrollton. They're going to be handled by this police force. And I'm not saying they're not good right now. They're great. I'm ticket free so far. I've never had like any bad interactions.
They're definitely awesome.
I've had awesome interactions with them. I've never had a bad interaction with a Carrollton police officer. They've always been nice to me. But we can pay them better in return and encourage the same nice folks to stay in Carrollton instead of going to other cities.
What do you see your daily responsibilities as a city council person?
The meetings. I pledge to attend basically all meetings, unless there's a family emergency, and in those meetings, giving thorough thought to anything that comes in front of you, going home, studying it, doing the finance, doing the math behind it, making sure if it makes sense or not, and then kind of listening for folks. I plan on, if I get elected, I plan on keeping up my Facebook page, and if there's anything critical, I will ask the public, like, hey, do you have any comments? What do you feel? And that way I can be the voice of the people and just do what my constituents want me to do.
Usama Ahmed, one of three challengers to Carrollton City Councilman Jim Waters for the Ward 3 City Council seat here in Carrollton. Usama, our guest this morning. Questions and comments, and do encourage you to post them to the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page, where you can see us streaming live this morning. Community Voice brought to you by Tanner Health System, Oak Mountain Academy. News Talk 1330 FM 106.3.
At Tanner, we're advancing health throughout West Georgia and East Alabama, because we know that exceptional care isn't based on how many patients we serve, but how well we serve them. That's why we're focused on quality, delivering the best possible care for our patients. It's why we're expanding our clinical services and building new facilities to serve our growing community. And it's why we're looking beyond our hospitals and medical practices to develop sustainable wellness and preventive health programs in our region. What makes a hospital great has changed. It's not how many beds we have. It's how well we care for the neighbors who need them. Delivering the right care to every patient, every time, is how Tanner is advancing health with medicine beyond measure. Learn more at tanner.org or find a physician on our medical staff by calling 770-214-CARE.
At Oak Mountain Academy, our daily schedule includes convocation, prayer, and the Pledge of Allegiance. By doing so, we build a family-like community where all students grow and flourish and personal faith is encouraged. Through community service and a historical approach to biblical study, our students are taught the value of the warrior way, honesty, respect, and responsibility. Oak Mountain Academy, we are a family creating legacies. To learn more, visit oakmountain.us.
.852. Welcome back to the WLBB Community Voice Program, News Talk 1330, FM 106.3. And this morning, we are streaming live on the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page. And I appreciate you guys tuning in there this morning. Jeannie Dollar typing in, yes, first responders, police are great here and definitely not paid anywhere near what they are worth. She also commented, really like your plans for the city by building on our community strengths and expanding for more Carrolltonians to enjoy, especially the farmer's market. 852, our guest, Usama Ahmed, one of three challengers to Jim Waters for the Ward 3 City Council race here in Carrollton. On Monday, Carrollton City Council and Mayor officially approved maintaining the millage rate. Current millage rate that does equate, though, to additional tax dollars being collected this year for Carrollton property owners as a whole, because tax digest did go up during the past year. What's your approach to ever raising taxes in Carrollton? When is that all right? How do you weigh that decision?
I just want to finish off my last thought on the police force on how we can increase their salaries, and then I definitely want to talk about millage after that, because that's a really important issue. One thing we can do right now to increase the pay for police officers is focus on certification-based pay. If they get more certifications, they can increase their pay. That way, you know, they get promotions and they can increase their average salary in the police force in general. To close that off, now, millage rate, they kept the rate the same. Now, it does increase revenue, so by the state makes you call it a tax increase. Essentially, it's not really a tax increase, it's the house price is going up. Right now,
It's just the house value that's going up.
So, yeah, the house value.
But they're collecting more money. The city's going to collect more money just because your house, in theory, is worth
more. Yeah. And in certain situations, I think it's okay. I was at the hearing there. I did get all the documentation. And one thing we need to realize is that in Carrollton, the millage rate has not increased since 1991 or 92, something like that. We still have one of the lowest millage rates in the West Georgia area. Like, I mean, I think the Carroll County's average is 8.26, and we're at 4.60. We're like half. And like even cities like Villarica like are like way higher than us. I have some here like Rome is 10.08. Cedartown is 11.20. So we already have a very low rate. And by keeping it same, they're increasing their revenue. And the reason this time it's okay, or I did not have any objections this time, is the economy is at a boom and we're expecting a recession. So if you're gonna decrease it, do it next time. Because people will be hurting more. Right now, I mean, I'm not saying that people are doing, everybody's doing fine right now, but if you're gonna do it any time where you just maintain the same rate, this time is as good as any. Hopefully there's no recession. God hope not, but it's looking like there might be one. And when it comes, then give the public some relief. And other, another thing people don't realize that on a $200,000 house, by keeping it the same, your tax is increasing by $21. That's about a dollar and some change a month. So the increase in general is not that high. People can obviously use the money if it is given back to them, but more relief should be done when the economy goes to through a downswing time period. While it's in an upswing situation, as they're keeping the rate same, they're not increasing it, and it's they have to like increase their reserves a little bit. There's big projects coming up too. The bank head corridor is coming up, and you know that's going to increase the house prices as well for people, everybody living around that area, and for the town in general. So this is going to pay off dividends, and it's not a big increase. As I said, the rate is the same, the revenue is going up, and it was passed by the city council unanimously. I do not have any objections to this so far, but let's say if a recession happens and they do this again, or if I'm at that situation, they do this again during a recession, then I will have a complete objection.
8:57, going to try and finish with this question. What do you see Carrollton's biggest issues within the next 4 years? And to say issues, not the end of the world type things, and what are the things that Carrollton is going to have to deal with?
Being a city that is starting to be a community of its own, where we are separate from Atlanta, we're not like reliant on Atlanta, and people can live here, work here, enjoy their life here, have enough employment here, have a decent community sense, like have still that small town feeling with all the amenities that they can have. And that I think that's going to be the biggest goal or objective, or also a problem on how to maintain that close-knit community where you welcome new people to, but at the same time, you don't lose the sense of who you are.
How do voters get in touch with you or learn more about you? Facebook, website?
You can search for hashtag Love Carrollton on social media. I do have a Facebook account, Osama for Carrollton City Council. You can go that and like that page. And once you like that page, I'll be posting updates to that. And I am a little bit old school as well. You can call me or text me at 770-873-3878. I have not figured out Instagram yet, but I plan on having an Instagram account soon too.
And if voters want to grab one of your signs, how do they get hold of those?
I will have some of those signs today at our debate that is being held by the League of Women Voters, and they can grab some signs there. And I plan on trying my best to go door to door and hand these out as well.
And that'll be at City Hall this evening, beginning at 6:30. Usama Ahmed, one of three challengers to Jim Waters for the Ward 3 City Council seat here in Carrollton, was our guest this morning. We appreciate you coming in. Good to see you. And we appreciate you listening and watching this on the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page today. Tomorrow, I believe we have our sponsors in on the Community Voice program. Representative for Tanner Health will be here beginning at 8:30. But then Thursday and Friday, we'll have two more candidates for that Ward 3 City Council seat here in Carrollton. Have a great Tuesday.
Thank you.